Hello, hello again, and welcome back to another tutorial in repairing cameras and lenses. Now, today I will show you how I have cleaned my, or will clean my my AF Nikkor 35mm 1.2. And yeah, I think it will be interesting. So let's have a look. But we need some tools. So this is how we actually need. I mean, a tweezer is very handy. A JIS. This is a real JIS. You can see it here. JIS. I don't know really what the S means, but well, this is a 2.5mm, and I would guess it's a JIS 00. It could be smaller, or I mean it could be a just a JIS. I also have the 2mm. This is the Moody tools, which I buy at the ifixit.com, and you can buy it at a really good price at the four different pieces. So it will be, yeah, you will see. Well, we also need those rubber cones, which you can get from Japan Hobby Tool. There are 6 pieces, and of course 12 different diameters, so it will be very handy. Some dentist tools, especially the spade here, is very handy. A lens socket. This is from also from Japan Hobby Tool, and the small one here is a company called Nordson. I think you can Google it, and it's called Nordson EFD. Oh, difficult to see. Well, there are some small. This is the biggest one, and there are some really really tiny for small parts or lenses. And this set is also very good when working with aperture blades. Now, we also need a lens spinner. This is a homemade from a Compass. I know you can buy them the real thing lens spinner, but this is only what I use. And so I file and grind the tip to fit in lenses. And the good thing is also it's adjustable and very steady. Now we need some cleaning tissues, which is a brand called PegPad, which I like. And I do a thing, I simply cut those big tissues in for smaller pieces, because it's more easy to work with, and of course cheaper. Now we need some cleaning fluid. In this video I will use lighter fluid. It could be this one called Extra Plus, or it could be some Zippo, which most people know. And we probably also need some nail polish remover with acetone, or you could also just use acetone, but it's a bit it's not so so good for your health. We also need a homemade tool. This is a end the rear cap, the lens. But in this video I will use the very back here to actually take off the plastic front nameplate, because it's not really that easy with this one. So I will simply cut 5 pieces of double adhesive tape and put it around the rear cap. So I have a kind of a tool that will make it a lot easier to remove the nameplate. And it's also very handy with other lenses, which have a difficult nameplate to get off. But this one, it really works. So simply just get off the wax paper. And then we have the tool ready. Come on, off with that. So can probably use other round thingy, but since you have a if you have a Nikon lens, well, you will probably also have some of those rear caps. So let's clear the table and get into the real thing. Oh, well, my monitor is in front of me, so I can see what I actually do. So, gosh, go away. Well, here we are. Let's take a look in what actually the lens actually look before I start to clean it. Well, not really good. There's a lot of things in there. So, and I think it would be okay. I mean, it's always worse to give it a try. And it's not that hard. So I will begin with the front lens group and simply use this tool to press on here gently and simply loosen it. And okay, it goes a bit too fast. What happened here? Not that good. So maybe I should use this one to loosen it. Yeah, it was not that loose, as I would say, but it will come easier when taking it off. Still, there are some still some tape on it, but it was simply too tight. But you see, I mean, this lens has, I have used it a lot, so things happen now and then because I hit it in the table, crash. So, well, let's jump into it. There are three screws around here, which you can see here, and I just set a mark here where the two small, yeah, I don't know what it is actually, but just to say that I set a mark here and there just to know where the position of the name, the ring here, the front ring, and the lens group. The front lens group should sit when I'm done. So off of those three screws, there is some lacquer on this, and when I unscrew those, it will be easy to see what's going on behind that. All three, okay. Well, take off this one. Okay, there's missing one screw here. Well, I just took a sneak peek in here. No, not really. There should only be two. Because the three other is there, that holds the name ring or front ring. So off with that. And you see, it's also good to have a mark that pointing somewhere where you know where it should sit. I could also just have put it here, but since I already put a mark here, where I can see it, is almost in line with the index mark. So it should be fine. Because I set marks, it's just so it will make it a lot easier to set it back in, I mean, assemble it again. Because there, I mean, you can find a repair manual for this lens, but if you do not have the repair manual, you just set some marks here. It will make it a lot easier. So now I can lift out the whole front lens screw, which looks like this, and well, it looks clear when you just look at it, but it isn't. Just put the lens aside. So here we are in here. It will be interesting to see how it will go, because I haven't been into the lens and cleaned it before. Now, there is a ring here on the back that needs to be unscrewed. There's something there, I'm not quite sure what it is. It looks like maybe it's fungus or something. So maybe I have to use some kind of hydrogen peroxide to probably clean it away. But let's see how it will go. Now, to unscrew this ring, I cannot use the lens spinner. So I will use the rubber thingy here and find the right diameter. This is too big. There's some here that could probably fit. They are a bit flexible. So let's see how it will go. So the other one I can use to, I'll use the bigger one, simply put it on here, and then probably unscrew it. Not? Well, now it's time to use some other tools, which I use a lot. It's actually very sticky garden gloves, which you can see here. They are really, really sticky, so it will help a lot, and you have good control over what you actually do. So just have a good grip and okay. Well, they have used some thread lock on here, so I probably need to use some nail polish remover and just on a cotton bud and see how it will go. Let's see, just a few drops of on a cotton bud. Oh, that was a little too much on it. And take care of use too much, because it will probably melting, or I mean soften plastic. So here we go. You see, it was actually quite easy to unscrew it right now, because the thread lock has been softened just a little. So now I can easy unscrew this retaining ring that hold the lens element. And now we are ready to actually do some cleaning. I will just try those finger condoms, because it simply works so much easier instead of using a gloves. So now I can just pull out this and I don't hope there is too much dust inside here, because how to actually go into that, the inside of the front lens. Well, let's see how it looks when looking with the help from a torch. Okay, there is something on, especially on the edge. Probably we can see there. So let's see how we can clean that. We also need some of those rubber lens tools, which is very, very handy when working with cleaning the lens element, because then you have a good stand to put the lens on. And I think I will begin with the back, most back lens element. Just put it on here. And because I begin with the very back of the front lens group, it's because when I turn it over, it have a better, it sits better, and not because the lens is completely flat on this side. So, well, I could also put it on here. It have a good shape here for this lens. Now, time to cleaning. And I will use lighter fluid because it works absolutely great in most cases. I could have used sensor cleaner. I mean, the Eclipse, but I most of the time prefer the lighter fluid. And not only cleaning once, I always, I mean, most of the time clean two times, because wow, it's absolutely clear. So let's turn it over and do the other side, and then take a look at how clean it actually is after this little treatment. So, there's still something on that I need to take off. So, and here we go. Okay, so let's see how it looks when taking a torch and put some light through it. Well, it's actually clean. I mean, the front of the torch is actually a bit dusty. Looks like there is something on the back here. So I'll just do it again. No one said it will work first. But, well, I could also try to use the Eclipse and see how it will go. Some also use acetone, but I haven't acetone right here. So I just use what I have. And do it again on the other side. Yeah, it's absolutely great. So put it aside and let's see how the front lens actually looks. Well, it's a bit actually a problem here, because if I want to take out the front lens itself, clean the backside, I need to cut away part of the plastic and simply push it out, and then I could just glue it in, or yeah, I don't know yet, but let's see if I just clean the front surface. See how it will go. It's an old lens, so the lens surface is not that good. But there's still something on. I don't know what has been used to clean the lens in the past. But okay. So I'll just try the lighter fluid, see how it will go. Well, it's not a new lens, so. But let's see how it will look through the. Yeah, I think it's okay. The backside of the front lens. So I will just put this piece in to place again. And then the front lens is done. Okay, there was always need a lens blower. So put this and put it in here. Simply just there, it's very tight fit, so I think really it will be fine. It's more the back lens group that is not so good and needs more attention than the front lens. So, and since it's plastic, it has a good fit, and I do not need to screw too hard in. So if we look here, yeah, the lens surface is a bit used, of course, it's an old lens, but it looks much better than it was. So let's jump into the back lens group. And since this is a non-D lens, is easy to actually work with, since we only need to take off the three screws that hold the mount and take the whole thing out, including the small electronic parts inside. But sometimes those screws on the lens mount can sit pretty tight. And if you use a Phillips screwdriver, you will probably damage the screws. But if they sit too tight, we simply use some, just a little amount of nail polish remover and simply dig over the screws so that it can come in and melting the, softening the thread lock on the three of those screws. So it is there. And it will absolutely work pretty good. So unscrew those three screws. There's also the gear, the screwdriver gear that we need to take care of and remember to put in when we're done. So there's no need to take off the contact here or the back ring here. And it will be more easier if you push the aperture pin all the way over. It's full open at the moment, so it shouldn't be a problem. But it's better you have a good grip and push it all the way over there, because the pin here on the back side that push against the cam here will be easier to put back in when you assemble the lens again. And also to set the aperture ring to 2. If I can get the gear into place. Okay, it falls out. Well, this is how it looks on the back. And this pin here push against the cam over here. So, and if we want to see it in life, real life, we simply take off this ring and let's see how it'll go there. So when you move the aperture ring, let's see if it can be going. If I move the aperture ring, I will move the back of the aperture system. So it is not a big problem. So, and take out the gear so we know where things are. Now put it to infinity here, so you have a better access to the back retaining ring. And again, where did it go? I can use my rubber tool to take it off, but if it's too tight, I would use my compass lens tool, whatever tool you have for this. So we have a good fit. And something like that, and simply unscrew it. hold on a second, just need to put caps on here so I not turn over. Now, the back lens group, there are more lens elements that we need to take care of. This is the very back, and it shouldn't be a problem to clean. It's not possible to take it out of the retaining ring because it's kind of glued in or put in. So, but oh, there's some dirt on the back. So I will just let's see, where do I go? There. No, this one. Put it there and see how it actually looks on the back side. I mean, on the inside of the lens. Just so we have a kind of a starting point. It's not that bad. It's more on the very back of the lens element. There's not really something inside here. And since it's impossible to take out of this retaining ring. But there isn't anything on here. It's more on the next lens elements, which has a very curved back. So take it out. I will use my my lens tool here. If it's strong enough, I think we'll use the other one instead. So this lens, sorry. Put it on and simply draw it out, and then it's free. So it is. And again, I will take the inside of the element first, because then it will be easier to the next site. Just need a new tissue. Mm-hmm. Oh, come on. So, here we are. So I think I will use the Eclipse, as you can see here. I think it works pretty good in some cases, not every time. And at the same, lighter fluid do not, it's not useful in every cases. Yeah, there are some hairs on the back. So we did it again. Do it again. Wow. It's absolutely clear. I think it's amazing how clear a piece of glass can look. I think we'll do it again. Just the final planing for this lens element. Here we are. And a place to put it aside. No, I think we'll use this one here. Now, the next lens, which is the inner lens element, there are some thing on, and I think I will just draw it out if I can. So it is, and that's the last element. And it looks okay. There are two sides. I mean, of course there are two sides, but one side which has a flat surface here on the all the way around, and the other have a very tiny edge. This is a more thicker edge, and this one has to face towards the front. So this one with the very thin edge here should be facing towards the camera. So let's see how it will look with a torch through it. Well, it's not really clear. There are some dust and specks on it. And I will use the clips. And see how it will go. Fine. So. There's something there, there's on here. Just a small hair. So now I can simply put the lens back in again and assemble the whole lens. So, and the next lens element. Put it on here. Wow. Nice. And simply put the retaining ring on here. Yeah. I think it will be fine. And since it's since the back here, I mean the whole lens in the internal tube here, helicoid, is made of plastic, so it's not a problem to actually tighten so, and it's really good. And yeah, so we'll put on all the things here. This ring here. And the gear. Okay, should have taken off this one. Put on the gear here. Oh, come on. So. Okay, try to catch the teeth. Okay. So here we are. Put on the cam here for the aperture and simply put on the mount. There is a hole here where the pin for the aperture goes in. You probably can see here. Put it in. And simply move the aperture here on the back so it goes directly on. So and now it works pretty good. Now the screws for the mount. I mean, you can use some thread lock like the Loctite 222, but in my case and my lens, I do not really do it that much, because then I can also disassemble it again. Mm-hmm. Now. And simply put on this, the front lens screw. Where did my mark go here? It's there. And my index mark is here. And I can simply just put it on. So it sits there. And on with the two longer screws. Not this one. This one here. Yeah, it's better. So it sits like there. This one, this hole here, or this, is for the. For the front name, for the front ring, actually. So, and the name, the front ring itself, and it sits there since I have a mark here. Difficult to see, I know. Since I have a mark here, I set in the beginning, and there's a mark here, so I know where things should sit when they sit correct. And then I can just put the ring on here, sit it correct. There, and the screw go in here. And we're almost there. Where did it go? The my tool here, the name ring, and hopefully it will be easy to put on there. Click, it says, in the thread. So, and if you need it, you can just tighten it even more. So it is, but how does it actually look when it's done? Well, since the lens is not new, I would say the result is actually okay. So this is how you can do this in an easy way and save money at the same time. So, well, that's actually all for me right now. So hope you enjoy the content. So bye bye.